Hello. Hello. Welcome to another weekly Stuff Picks, and let me just begin with this for now. I hope this will work. I hope this will work. Okay, so that worked. Very nice, because I was pretty nervous that it will not work. So welcome to the weekly Stuff Picks. Thank you, Matt, from Madcat. Madcat, both of them actually, for this wonderful intro to our, and actually even more stuff that he has built and created for tomorrow's event. I hope you all will be joining there. We'll be knocking our heads out, and not feeling friendly to each other. So please join us tomorrow for the Unreal Tournament 2004 Championship. This will be a very huge event. We have prepared and planned a lot for you guys. So back to today's, as you can see, gods will be watching. This week's weekly Stuff Picks are about survivalism. It's even called Survivalism 101. By the way, hello all. Hello Outstar, and thank you for the wonderful stream. Hello Chris, Memories in 8-bit. Hello Mad Cat. Hello Dark Daedalus. Hello Alphador, Dalvino, Hatnix, Atskana, everyone. Welcome here. I hope my sounds are okay. Let me put on some fire here. Where's my window? Okay, here's my window. And of course, hello Inquisitor. Okay, so this game, actually, this is the second time it's being streamed on Gokom's channel. The first one was during the Screaming Joypad charity stream, and it was an interesting thing to watch. Hey Spectrum. Unfortunately, we didn't hear a lot for what he was speaking about since we were. But we are all in the office. We were all watching him and speaking about this game, how hard it is, and how what kind of moral choices you have to make actually to go through all these levels. I have played like through three chapters, and it wasn't very. It's even hard to describe. Like it wasn't a super fun game, but it was very interesting to try to manage all of this. And this is a pretty hard game. I am mentioning this again, but this is a pretty hard game. Back to our promo, we also have prepared for you today Banished, which is Ada's favorite. I hope you saw Ada playing Raymond with Conrad and me as Matt. So this is our selection, and all gods will be watching, and plus special edition upgrade, which adds the soundtrack and some comics. By the way, the soundtrack is cool. It's really nice. It's really atmospheric. It's really chill, I would say. And you should check it out. So I will be playing. I will be playing. I'll show what to actually be playing. You have a choice of multiple levels of I forgot the word. How hard the game is. You have original, which is harsh, unforgiving, and evil. It makes you fail a lot. A very, very lot. It's really the Mike. Wait a minute. I hope I'm not mixing. Difficulty, of course, difficulty. Mike was streaming this for like 1 hour, I think. He didn't pass the first level. This is the original difficulty. This is where you're. You are spending a lot of time trying to deal with this situation where you're put into, and it's not easy. You have in the first level, you have hostages, you have guns, you have someone trying to breach you, and it's like it's hard. I have tried to play it on original. I didn't pass it first level also. Hope, fortunately, and I'm glad that it exists here. You have couple of more difficulty levels. This is the original light, and I think we will be playing this today, which is kind of this. It's not as easy. It's like a medium difficulty, or easy, so to say. It just gives you a bit of chance, and I think this mode is the best for streaming because it's more. Gives you a challenge and also shows how hard it is. Puzzle mode, which adds a lot of random things, and it's just puzzles. That's it. No randomness. And puzzle mode light. Narrative mode is the easiest one. It basically you're just going through narratives and it doesn't challenge you at all. And that's it. So let's start the new original light game and see how we will go. Wait a minute. I almost overridden my save. Ah, okay, this is yes, of course. And I will have to narrate it a bit since it doesn't have any voices in this game. By the way, my UT skills, Unreal Tournament skills, average. I wouldn't call me a very awesome FPS player. I'm not that good at it as other guys are. So I would say average. We'll see. Maybe I will be stressed out and I will just be in the bottom. Yes, Alfador asked if the narrative mode is basically a visual novel. It still has the puzzles. It still has the puzzles, and you have to solve the puzzles. And but it's you can go through it very fast. Like it just doesn't make you suffer, and doesn't make you make those hard consequences as you would have in original mode. So I'll get into that later, and you will see what kind of choices you have to make. And by the way, all Star Wars fan, may the 4th be with you. Congratulations on this day. I'm not myself a very big Star Wars fan, but I hope you enjoyed the last week with all the Star Wars themed stuff going on around. Okay, let's jump into the game. So we are as Sergeant, we're playing as Sergeant Burden mainly, and we're going through this story. Hang in there, team. We'll get out of this, I promise. To steal our research, I can understand that, but how can they hate us so much? To abandon us to our death on this frozen planet. So apparently they are on some frozen planet. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 members. This is not hate. Xenolifer did this for the sake of their mission. If they hated us, they would have executed us. But Jack says, "Oh, I see. This is your comfy of mercy burden. This looks far worse than a shot in the back of the head to me. We are alive, aren't we? Like, being stranded on all this planet Earth. I can get you out of here. Liam knows that. Xenolifer aren't assassins. They're freedom fighters. In the end, their objective is to free all intelligent alien races from slavery." Yeah, how noble. I don't give a fuck. Oh, by the way, if you have any minors or you are a minor, this game isn't for you. It's tough. It's I think this should be like N18 or I don't know. In each country is different, but yeah, it will be a lot of swears and blood and that stuff. So if you can't handle it, just unfortunately, you shouldn't be here. And this is point and click adventure game. Jupiting, by the way, hi. So Donald says, "I hope the Constellar Federation crushes them once and for all." So we have two factions, the Constellar Federation and the other one, which is fighting for some alien freedom forces. We have Dr. Zinesh. "I respect their cause, but I definitely disagree with their methods. Nothing good can be achieved through terrorism. Terrorism is just a word used by big nations to define small opposing forces. The way the Constellar Federation obliterates its enemies and enslaves the defeated aliens is far more terrifying to me. But I disagree with the violent methods of Xenolifer 2, Doctor. That's why I joined the Everdust Company for the universe knowledge. Isuk's neutrality and respect for justice, science and truth over all the things is something I can respect. Without any political or religious agendas to justify their actions, just common sense." No common sense. Jack says, "Yeah, it's great how the Everdust keeps getting us into trouble. I love them." Jack. "I'm sorry, but I'm just really angry. Fucking Xenolifer. Fuck them. And welcome to the chapter 1. Self-justified sacrificers." So we're going back 1 year ago. And we have... it seems Xenolifers hacking into some Federation stuff. Ah, okay, so we can now go to fruit dialogues. So we have Liam, which is good work, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention for a minute? This siege is an act of Xenolifer. You are being held as our guests while we retrieve your outstanding research data on the Medusea virus. Seriously, good job analyzing that little bitch. The revolution will greatly benefit from your contribution to the scientific community. Now, let my friends do their work, and I promise nothing will happen to you. Jack, don't let those damn guards near us. He's got them, boss. Chiman, keep the network stable while I'll hack into their database. I'm looking forward to see the power of your improved hack boost tool firsthand. So this basically... introduces us to all the characters in the game and who is who and what he can do and sorry. They won't see me coming. And you, Abraham, you are in charge while I'm plugged into this thing. Mind the hostages. Don't let them get so comfortable that they think they can save themselves. Ignore them for too long though, and you'll have a revolt on your hands. Don't scare them to the point of trying a suicide escape either. While I'm plugged in, I'm counting on you to lead the team in their tasks. Aid Jack with his negotiations while keeping an eye on Shaman's work and the network status. Basically, keep the situation under control until my hacking reaches 100% and our mission will be complete. And it'll be my pleasure. And we will be basically playing as Abraham. And Abraham, don't hesitate to ask us anything that won't take much time. Xenolifer, let's do this. So, he's hacking. Now we have the control of everything. We have the... So these are the guards who will be... who are trying to attack this and to stop our hacking here. We have all the hostages, we have no idea what's their name, this is some kind of a doctor. It seems actually that kind of they are the ones that were near the fire, so basically they are the ones. So how is this displayed? Basically, you are interacting with everyone in the situation. So we have Liam, we can talk with him, so he will explain us something. Like, remember, we aren't terrorists here, keep the casualties to a minimum. So we're basically trying to do some good cause. We can ask about him, and we have this... There are a lot of... dialogue options to choose from, and you can just get to know some more information. I will not go through all of them. There's a lot to read and a lot to ask actually, and to know more about each character in the game. Just for the sake of showing off this game, I will just go through minimal amount of them. So, for example, we can ask about the hack boost and how it works, and he will say that the hack boost is a powerful net hack tool, but it requires a great amount of preparation. The more you charge it, the more successful it might be. If you unleash a successful hack boost, the hacking progress will move forward considerably. And gotcha. So we have this hack boost. Hack boost success rate, which basically the thing which he was talking about. We have the security, which will be hacked by those Federation guards, and we can actually hack the camera to see what's done in the corridor. So if you have noticed in this, for example, dialogue selection, you have the green green options and red options. So green options are free in terms of time, and they are not advancing time in any way, and the red ones are advancing time. So after a red option, you are basically advancing all the time, and some things happen. So for example, we are let's negotiate with the Federation, with the guards. So if you have noticed that the hostages will try to get Tucci and not so relaxed. So I can, for example, calm them down. And they are already changed their stance. But for example, you have to keep an eye on the camera. Because the guards are advancing. You have to keep an eye on security in here, because it just dropped to 80% after those two actions, basically. The one was negotiating with the guards, the second one was talking with the hostages and keep calming them down. You have also a choice, you have a choice of calm down, so you're basically chatting with them, but this is not working in more stressful situations. You can shout at them, which is making them stressful, but also at the same time calmer. Of course, you can kick. You can trade, but just let's not get into that option. You can shoot them, since you have the gun and you have an option to do that. You can shoot the leg, you can shoot the face, and you can forgive something. We can trade, as you have seen, and you can trade for you can trade with the guards. Actually, you're giving out the hostage, and you're asking them for some basically net stability. You're asking them to go back, and you're asking for medicine. So you can go like in this what's the word? Not so harsh. Not so harsh, and like not you're not acting as a terrible terrorist, or as an actual terrorist which they're trying to pose themselves as. Okay, so our goal is basically to move this hacking progress to 100%. I will try to, I don't know how you guys want to proceed this with try to calm the situation, trade the hostages, or be badass terrorists and just shoot everyone in the legs or in the face or whatever, so they are, you know, more afraid. Just let me know in the chat. I'll definitely, there are a lot of choices, and you will see the different outcomes of this game. Okay, so hey Padak, okay, so let's basically in this situation where we have to charge the hack boost, because it will take less time to hack the system. perhaps you can go through this level without the hacking, but it will take a long time, because he's hacking very slow. Okay, so it's cool, actually it gave us 26%. So how are our hostages doing? Of course we can move in some places, move around, and you will see the situation. For example, this is the break room, and too much stressed hostages can actually be moved here, so they will be relaxed much more. But this is like, this requires a lot of experimentation, since you have to not keep them for a long time there. If you keep them too long, they are basically running away, and then you have nothing to do but to shoot them. If they run, you are shooting them. There's no other option. You can't stop them, beat them to, I don't know, knock them out, or say them, oh, don't run, please. They're just, you know, running, and they're trying to attack you, and that stuff. So, Syntax asked, can you give up and go to prison for years? No, unfortunately, no. You have to go through this, all of this situation, all of this. Okay, our hostages are doing kind of okay-ish. The guards are here. Security assist 69. I think we can hack it. We can charge once more. So, for example, since our security was at 69, this was a bit risky move. So it will be if the guards, which are also hacking you, hence the security system, will try to hack you and shut you down. So right now we have to reinforce security to get everything up back again. Yeah, Jeputing says that just send them into the back room to chill on the armchair and read some books. That should calm everyone down. Well, it does for a little bit. Of course it does, when they are completely stressed and they have no idea what to do. But then again, you have to keep an eye on them. So, for example, this this camera thing is basically you can hack it to break room or corridor. So if you hack it into break room, which is free, so we are not spending the time, you see the situation in the break room, but you can't see the situation with the guards. So if they're coming close, you are not seeing that, and you have to check it all the time. So it depends how you want to play this through. So for me, it's more about monitoring the corridor and the hostages are okay, we have to speak with this hostage because he seems that it's already see? He just stood up. I should have like shouted on him or something like that. So he's like, he's down. We just shot him. And now the guards are moved. And now other hostages will be stressed much more. Ah, god damn it. Okay, so let's negotiate with them. Let's charge the boost again. They seem to be not so. Okay, let's execute the hack boost. We have like 94%. I think it's quite okay to do that. Okay, so we have like 25% hacked already. Can we actually send him? We can try to send him to break room. Let's send him to break room. Let's hack into the break room and see. We have to reinforce security again because it's at 60%. So the doctor is trying. Oh my god, the doctor is already. Ah, so we can send them both of them. Okay, so I have to send him back. But that's too early. Oh my god, I might have made a mistake actually, and I will kill all my hostages. Crap. Okay, let's charge it up. Let's see how the cards are doing. Oh, damn it, they're close. Okay, okay. That guy is trying to run. Damn it. You just need to what? You just need to what? You know what, let's trade him for... Then ask them to go back. Let's be... Nice. Oh, and you actually have to still keep an eye on the hostages all the time, because, for example, they say he's distracted. So she means that something will happen. And right now it's either she will start running if I'm doing with her something, or she will calm down, which is like randomly happening. So you're basically have a random chance in this game, especially when you are playing the original one. It's just, you never know what happens. You never know. Let's calm her down. She doesn't like that. Let's shout. Don't waste my time, scum. That didn't help. She's still kind of stressed. Oh, and they're still coming. Oh my god, they're still coming forward. That is not a good thing. Okay, we have to reinforce that. Can we actually negotiate with them? When you're negotiating, you're actually stopping them at the same place, so they will move after some more turns. I don't know. Can I actually, how she will run, or he will run actually. She will run. Yes. Well, we have the second hostage down. Damn it. So we have one hostage left, and we have 50% to hack, which is... No! Okay, let's execute our hack boost. Of course, the guards will move in already. 3, 2, 1, execute. Oh my god, so little. So little. One hostage. I have no idea. I don't know. I think we'll lose him. Yeah, he's trying to. Come on. Come on. Shit. Should I kick him? Or should I shoot him? No. I wonder if I can shoot his leg actually and then patch it up. Because there is like medical supplier. And there is flesh reparation kits. Two flesh reparation kits. I have never tried this actually, so I'm sorry guys, but I will shoot him in the leg. Just because we have one left and we have like almost 30% done left for hacking. So damn it. Okay. Uh-huh, so we can shoot him and cure him after some time. Okay. Oh, damn it, the hearts cards are moving. I can actually attack him. Oh, come on, no, they're so close. For example, yeah, he's also has this moral choice and he doesn't want to attack this because he's under stress and he feels bad about that. So you have a choice to reprimand him, apologize and desist, but we'll try to go nice and reprimand him and we were out of time. We're out. We'll have to redo this. Damn it. Damn it. 83%. My approach to the situation has been soft. Okay. Let's do this faster this time, since I will not have to explain anything, so. Let's... Alright, let's charge him. We're negotiating, so they will stay for a few turns in there. Let's charge it again. And let's charge it again. Okay, they're happy about that, but too happy to reinforce that. Okay, let's negotiate again, so they are not moving. Okay, she's trying to play some interesting things, and let's not waste our time and just try to intimidate them a bit. Let's execute our hack boost. Okay. They are kind of calm. We have two medkits, so basically we can shoot two legs or two faces. Yes, Whisker, it consists much more. And basically these are the... Each situation is like this and you have to move on and on and on and on through this. Maybe, I save in the narrative mode, so maybe actually I will go through the narrative scene. If I will not manage to go through this quite fast, I will switch into the narrative save, and then we can go much more deeper into the game and you will see where it is. But it's just it skips one scene, so it skips one chapter, so maybe that's more interesting that way, huh? Okay, what I was doing. Okay, these are okay. Let's charge it. Damn it, she's again. Let's shoot her to the leg. Let's reinforce security. I hope she can still spend some time like that. Okay. Let's negotiate so they are not coming back. Let's cure the girl. Cure. Damn it, the hacking is so slow. Ooh, that's a good jump. That's a good jump. Well, we'll have to kick the doctor. Well, he can't take it anymore, but... Okay, let's free the... Oh my god, this will be harder. Whew. Yeah, I think yeah, I agree that it's hard to stream if you're trying to play this in the original mode. Even in this one, like in this mode, it's quite hard. But let's rush through it a bit. Ah, damn it! Damn it! I will have to shout. He needs to run. Ugh. No! No more killing. No more running. I'm mad. Come on. Damn it. Damn it. You see? That's Russian. That's completely Russian. That's completely Russian. That's basically we have. Can we complete this? Nope, they're just taking us down. That's it. Bam. This game judges you a lot. Well, okay, let's damn it, actually I have to finish this. No, you know what? Let me switch to narrative mode. Since I showed you how hard it is actually, even in the lighter mode, how hard it is to pass it. Maybe just for me, while I'm streaming right now, it's much more difficult to do that because I did that before. Yes, I meant rushing, not Russian. So let's go to the narrative mode. Yes. Is this safe? Yes. And we have the same conversation in the forest, near the fire, in a completely cold planet. Oh, by the way, I'm skipping the initial cutscene again, so it's not taking more time. Okay, so in this one it should be pretty easier, because we can charge very much of everything, and the hacking is going much more faster. Oh, I have to charge it full. Okay. And the hostages are not stressing out this time, and no, everything is much faster. So it can, you can just go through the game and see how about that. But I really recommend this to play this at least in original light or original mode, because it will. You will have to make choices, and you will have to make pretty hard choices at some places. Oh my god, they are all stressed out already. Jesus. Okay, they are a bit calmed down. Let's charge the boost again. Not so far left. Let's not fail this one. Let's trade this hostage and be nice and ask them to go back. Let's charge it a few times. And let's execute, and I think that will be enough for now. Alright, we have got the data. And we're done. So, still the guards are trying to attack us. But, we are in a completely different situation right now. And he's telling for Abraham and Jack to Abraham and Jack, basically you're the sergeant here and the Jack is your partner in the situation. You're just caught. But they're saying that you have to go and just lead on the revolution and don't care about them, about us, about me. So he promises that he will return and rescue them. And this is a very interesting actual. After each chapter, you see the statistics of your choices. And for example, I freed one hostage. And I hope it takes it from some live internet. I actually didn't check that. I forgot to do that. But for example, 63% didn't free any hostages at all. For example, 34% killed one hostage. 31% didn't kill any hostages. Your favorite demand, and basically it has. You didn't fight with Jack. Oh, actually, you could have fought with Jack because he could create some conflict that. And my attitude was soft. Yes, because I traded one hostage, so come on. And we have chapter 2, 20 days of empty words. And we are in Xenolifer's mothership, 3 days before the space lab data hijacking. So it takes time, takes you back. It was 1 year before, now it's 3 days before. And he is communicating someone. So this is Sergeant Burden communicating from within Xenolifer's matrix battleship, requesting an encrypted Type 6 comm relay to the Everdust company for the universe knowledge. So he's basically infiltrated the Xenolifer's organization, and he's trying to bring them down from the inside. So he's communicating with them after 3 months. And he broke the protocol, but he had to break it to actually reach the Lime, which is the main leader of the Xenolifer's organization. And here he's reporting to his bosses that about the situation. So he's providing that information that he's trying to. That Liam is trying to attack the lab, which we already played through, and the research data and all the status that you are. This is the part of the story. He gets a new order to eliminate Liam. And they have this conflict that it's not okay to kill the leader because he has gained his trust and he can do it in a peaceful way, but he can't because the bosses are requesting him to do it in not peaceful way, and they're kind of a terrorist organization, but they're kind of not a terrorist organization, and it's hard to know who is who for now from this situation, from this beginning of the game situation. Like, for example, they're not terrorists, they have ideals of revolution, but Liam isn't genocidal, I know him, sir. And they don't like it because they think it will be kids' compromised loyalty. And you, as a Sergeant Burden, the main guy you're playing, it doesn't seem that you're playing him, but it, you are. You're taking the responsibility, and you're kind of trying to convince your bosses that you're right. So this is the second chapter, and it's a torture chapter, and yeah. Oh yes, Podak, I have not yet played through the last part of Lifeless Planet. A bit of lack of time, but I will definitely I will just stream that someday. Actually, I did not choose the day yet, but I will stream that for sure. But it will be on my channel. It's small, but I'll try to find a time, because The Witcher will be released in 2 weeks, so you know. We're preparing a lot. So we are in Irving's hands. His name is Irving, and the big boy with him is Alexander. Alex. Doesn't speak much, but he's a good fella. That is, unless you piss him off. but that ain't gonna happen, right? So we are hostages in this, and I have no idea. We have no idea what which part we are belonging to. So this is the this is the Federation ones. Yes, of course, this is the Federation ones, and they want to know what we were doing on their lab. What we were doing on their lab. Hello, Peter 126 Rus. I'm trying to decode that, but I can't actually. So I'm sorry if I misspelled some your nick. So, first question: who do you work for? Oh, now I can do something. Oh, okay. So this is me. This is Jack, my partner, and I can provoke, beg, think, or lie, but it's 10% lie, so I have no, like, I can't use it. And I can confess, and the same thing I can do with Jack. So basically, in here, I'm choosing who to torture, myself or my partner. It's... but let's torture him. So, if we are provoking him, we're getting a smack into the face. Okay, let's provoke us also. Like, why the hell are you wearing sunglasses in the basement? Smack to the face. Not many people dare to challenge the Holistic Empire, so where are you idiots from? If I remember correctly, if I'm thinking, I actually am increasing my lie percentage, but we both are getting smacked. You should be proud of your actions. Just recover the little pride you have left and tell me your faction's name. Yes, so the lie jumped from 10% to 77%, which is a lot in the narrative mode, and I imagine you would spend an hour in this chapter just trying to keep the beating to minimum, but still receiving because you are receiving it after each choice, and not die. Just somehow. You have an option to confess, and basically confessing is telling the truth about that. But if you're confessing too much, again, you're kind of, I don't know, giving out everything. Yeah, so for G-Pudding and for everyone who joined here, we are tortured. After each answer, we are getting smacked, either one person or another, or both. So we can try to beg this time. Yes. Actually, having headphones on is much more how would you say this? Much more in, it puts you more in the game, and the slapping, the not the slapping, but actually the smacking in the face is kind of giving the shivers a bit. Can we lie? No, he's not ready to lie yet. Can I provoke him just? Yes, don't waste your time and start beating us. Who do you work for? Let's provoke again. Come on, hit me, Blondie. Alexander, stop. Look at what time it is. We'll miss the Holistic Baseball League. Gentlemen, you'll have to excuse us. So, I hope you enjoyed your first session. Ha, this is going to be fun. Good night, fellas. And this is not the end. So, you think we've been through worse than this? We are alive, aren't we? For now, let's just focus on staying that way. Okay, until when? I don't know, but as long as we are still breathing, we have a chance. Don't do or say anything stupid, we have to choose our words wisely. I don't care about giving up information about Xenolifer. But as soon as this lunatic knows everything he wants, we're dead. Yeah, sounds like a solid plan. Shut up and get some rest. The worst is yet to come. So basically, after this first torture session, it's telling you about more about the situation. The game is telling you more about the situation you are in, and how to actually survive through this. Did you know that Alexander loves hamsters? How sweet. He has an entire collection of legless, eyeless, toothless, hairless, brainless hamsters. Not all at the same time, I mean. Each one is customized with delicacy. Actually, I kinda introduced him to the hobby. I remember, as a kid, a hamster was one of the best gifts no one ever gave me. It really brought out my passion for torturing at an early age. I'll never forget hearing Mr. Dimitri. What a lovely set of screams he had. And you? When are you going to scream? This isn't going to be easy, Irving. I think we have a strength of at least 10,000 hamsters. So he's again asking about our organizations. Organization. Let's think a bit more. Ow. We are actually receiving hammer hits to our knees. Donny Murray, this is my character being tortured, and we are in this mess. Really. We're working for neutral organization, but we are in the terrorist organization, and we're caught by some evil empire organization, so... So where we are from? Can we actually... I think we can confess this one. We have the lie of 100%, but... we don't have a lot of life left, of course. So we work for Xenolifer, enemies of the Constellar Federation. Interesting, so you are members of Xenolifer, terrorists who hide behind revolutionary ideas, but there are still many things that bug me. What are you looking at our lab for? I think this one we have to lie. We wanted to steal all the intel we could from the Holistic Empire. Information is power. Makes sense, doesn't it? I don't know. Next question. Who are you? This one I can provoke Jack, I think, because I'm a bit worn already. Did you dress yourself, or did Irving pick your pants for you? Ow. My name is Irving McAllister. See? It's not that complicated. Yeah, it is a bit. Let's think more. Ow. Damn, I have to take a shit, says Irving. Alexander, I told you we shouldn't have attended that jalapeno party. See you tomorrow, amigos. Oh, you know what they say. Eat fire, shit tears. We have actually some interesting dialogues. I must say that, really interesting. Pizza. Did you say something? I'm starving. You should try biting his fist next time. Meat is meat. Have you noticed you make a lot of jokes about cannibalism? Wasn't a joke. Oh, we have visitors. And look who is that. It's Liam. So he's late and he's here and he's... they're trying that... They're thinking that he will rescue them, but actually he will not, because that's not a good idea. Because they're in the prison, which is located on one of the wandering moons of the Holistic Empire, and this giant rock is too heavily guarded for a prison break. It's a miracle he got this far. I don't think we can make it together. Hell. I don't know if I can make it back alone. Well then, grab a chair and take a seat. What's the plan? I know you have one, Liam. So, he's a suicidal hero, but not a suicidal idiot. And Xenorifer, his organization, is preparing the mission. The plan needs them to endure torture for 20 more days. So basically the game says that in general, to be saved, you have to go through all those dialogue options for 20 days in a row. It's a lot. And yes, you know, clever plans usually are not the quickest plans. So he is here to help, and he has located a nursery nearby, and he will sneak and steal the medication. So again, here the game introduces what options you have and what more choices you will have to you will be able to make to withstand all those 20 days, and you will have the health, which will may help you, which will help you endure longer. You will have painkillers, which allow you to resist more pain. And you will have information, which will basically allow you to lie, actually at the same moment. So you will not have to build up the lie percent. You can do that upfront, right? After you get the information. What should he bring tomorrow? Healing kit. Apple Child, they are topless because they are being tortured. If you ever saw a torture scene in a movie, or you have been tortured, or you have been torturing someone, usually this helps to introduce more pain into the body. Don't ask where I know this from. So, do you like games, Chad? He's really into gambling games, and he's familiar with the old, because this is in the future, old gunpowder weapons. And this is a 7-barreled Lucky Revolver, which hasn't been in his family for centuries. And, surprise, surprise, we will be playing Russian Roulette. I don't know what Russian means, but must be the guy who invented it. True. So basically he is pointing this one with one bullet, if you're not familiar with Russian Roulette, and asking a question. If he likes what we will answer, he will pull the trigger. Either way, you'll be in the hands of Lady Luck. Are we ready? Are we ready? One for one out of seven chances of boom. Tell me your names. So, what should we do? How do you think? What should we do? Provoke, beg, think, or confess? We can't lie because it's 70%. I don't know. For one out of seven, we actually can provoke them, because one out of seven. Okay. For one out of six chances. What exactly, who he's dealing with? Let's beg for mercy. You know, actually right now, this reminded me of This War Is Mine. And this is the second sad and hard game I have played. Which is... yeah. I saw a question why the guard is also topless. Well, because he's a brute and I don't know, he wants to show off, or the Irving was dressing him up, or what the hell. I don't know. Let's think so we can lie. Oh, he's resetting. Let's lie. My name is Samuel Kinners and he's Orson Blomkvist. We were rebels from the Legin Desert. So he has had enough. And he would use a wand called beer for now. So basically the torturer is has some questions that he asks you, and he wants the information about that, and you can answer those questions by thinking something up, by lying. He will be asking you them all over, like again and again and again and again, and you basically can try to lie everything out, or you can try to balance and make them believe that they are getting some true information. So they are now discussing about Liam. Where do you think Liam comes from? Why do you think he began this revolution? He told me he was from a huge high-tech planet. He was a speck of dust on a very dirty planet. And he came to be some kind of rebel punk who led a big group of youngsters against the big corporations. This Xenolifer group is reminding me of Greenpeace. So Jack is questioning him whether Burden is not too close actually into this Liam guy, because they're pretty close and he isn't, but he just calms him down by saying that he's a good listener. Although they look like shit, don't die on him. Don't worry, Abraham here won't let me die. And teamwork will make the torture a lot easier to withstand. Okay, so let's get information for tomorrow. Oh, and he brought us medicine. That's very nice. I see you guys are excited about the physics in the incoming Wild Hunt. I think they will be done pretty well, because I don't remember actually in which trailer, but I saw them moving very, very good. Very good. So, life at the Holistic Empire has its ups and downs, but I wouldn't change it for anything. And you know why? Human rights. Human rights, guys. To which the Holistic Empire is not giving a shit to. At all. You get what you deserve thanks to your own strengths. Fuck equality. Yeah, this situation makes a perfect scenario for his line of work. Oh my god, did you see Jack? He's on a wall. And I think you can imagine what will happen to him. I'm actually waiting to see whether the beard physics will work as much as the hair physics, like the wind blowing and moving your beard all around. We'll see. Now, since I can compare it to how in real life it works. So, yeah, they have the baseball league where you can brawl, you can kill, you can take your glove and even smother a guy. Hence, this is a true sport. Yeah. Yeah, baseball where everyone is just fighting, just called baseball. And his favorite player is Ozzy Aldozat, has a streak of 10 kills in 9 matches. 10 kills, very nice. So, what are we trying to do with the intel we stole? I will tell what happened after when I was playing this chapter. We can't lie. Damn it, I don't know if I can provoke them actually, because this will happen. Let's think. That was one. Damn it. Let's confess this one. Oh, this is a Samo. You say you wanted to blackmail. But there's still things. Who's your boss? Who's our boss? Can I think? Shit. No, I am not happy. I didn't know that he will be turned into two from like second time. God damn it. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. It's not funny if you don't care. Damn it. Yes, he went into pieces over that answer. Two, to be precise. He will make us cry. So we just gave a speech to Irving. And we have Jack back again? How? What? What? He was just like repaired or something like that? What the fuck? Is he my imagination? Yeah, he's my imagination. Nah, I'm not affected by puppies that much actually. Damn it. Yes, this blood is on you, Liam. You should have listened to me. and done something about it, not for like 20 days keeping us here and making Jack torn into two pieces. Damn it. So what did you expect when you started your revolution? And he's still not seeing us. That ass. What should you bring? Painkillers. Let's choose painkillers for next time. So he got a intel also that about some Kernsmith bandit family. So he asked us about the boss. Maybe we can actually use this name for that. Oh, come on, I'm not a puppy murderer. Just, I don't... They're not affecting me when they're like cute photos on Facebook or whatever. Welcome back to another day of the disturbingly pleasant Irving and Alexander show. Are you ready for this? And yes, Metal Addict, that's right, that it has this kind of graphics that if it would be photorealistic, it would be pretty nasty. Pretty nasty. I even don't want to think about that. That's damn. Oh, and poor Alexander is looking into him very strangely, it seems, but we can't tell from this setup. Our friend. I think that Alexander and his annoying friend would be a better title. Haha. And we're going to pay for that comment. Tell me everything about your leader. So that's the final question. Let's provoke him. We have some health left, right? So that's 1 out of 32, right? Or 30, or 28. Yes, that's true, Metal Addict, that this game makes Banished You look like a happy hippie game. Right. Who is my leader and what is he planning? Let's lie. How did we manage to enter the space lab? Okay, let's fuck. Let's provoke him again. Let's lose another tooth. Oh, actually that's hurt. And they are leaving us again. Oh, that reminds me that I'll probably kill you soon. If the date goes smoothly, I'm gonna need that chained wall. Bastard. Oh my god, bastard. Oh yes, Alphador, I went through that scene twice. Like, the first time I was playing and the second time I was playing. So, the first time was... How should I put it? Very bad, like, and at the same time, it was super awesome because Rockstar is the company that has balls to put the scene into the game. It's really not easy for I imagine that it's not very easy for some players to go through that scene But still, it's like, for example, the one that was pouring the water over his face covered with some stuff was pretty nasty, pretty nasty. How did you guys feel about that, if you have played the fifth one? So between the tortures, they're basically talking about stuff and getting deeper into the story. And no, Applechild, he's not enjoying. I don't think he's enjoying that. Maybe, but that's not very possible. It's just because I let them take out two teeth with just a piece of pliers, and that's nasty. Yes, Jack was killed. Jack was torn into two pieces on that wall he's standing right now. Like, just... That's it. Okay. And the ninja is coming right now. Is everything all right? Yes, you're answering yes to that. Oh my god. He will mourn Jack with a drink. But now he owes this torture to him. Okay, I need a healing kit actually. Oh! Oh! I'm rescued by... Oh, we're rescued by our bosses. Damn. So they basically don't know who Liam is, because there's some unknown person, and they are leaving him there. So we're... They're losing on the chance to actually catching him, and Liam realizes that he's the sergeant. Whew. Okay. My attitude was smart, and actually 53% chose suicide. Damn. We confessed two times. There was an option for Jack to lose his arm? Ooh, that is more nastier than the split. Everdusk. Oh look, there's a puppy for you. Okay. What the hell? They are bringing that back there. There's some action going behind. So basically, we are back after the rescue mission, and something has changed the rules. Aha, so they have the virus. Wait, so we are back to present day? Well, I don't think I will torture the dog in this chapter, but I'm making these decisions for you guys because I know that they are not super easy to make for some people. Just they can't, you know, like they will stop play this game if they will see that this guy is like torn into two pieces, or this dog is like tortured away or something like that. So this is for you. Alright, so he's trying to... we're basically ordered that we have to fight for this threat, because the terrorist organization by them has the virus and he's deadly. And they basically don't have any antidote for this. So for the next mission, we will have to spend several months of the surface of Cynikos. And Cynikos is the homeworld of the Medusa virus. So you will be leading an Everdusk science team whilst occupying the planet. Your mission won't be complete until you find a cure for the Medusa virus. So, yeah. Oh, Jack. Oh, Jack is still here. Come on, he's dead. What the hell? Damn it, I don't understand. Is he dead actually, or is he just a robot? Because... So we have psychiatrist and brain genetics. We're meeting our team. We have Dr. Paul Senesh, expert in bacteriology, bionics, and former chief of the counterviral department of the Counterstellar Federation. So this is all the team that were at the start of the game, near the fire. I think they're all there. So no one dies. Yes. Okay, so Donald is a maintenance guy, and the mechanic and the robot guy, and he's taking the experimental mode. Experimental robot, which was designed to analyze human emotions and status to try and please its owner and guests. So basically it's a sex bot, right? Maybe it's a good thing to bring into the death mission on a cold planet where the deadliest virus of all is living. Salvador, maybe he will just turn red and he will go wrong, or maybe rogue, but I think he will just pleasure the owner and his guests so much that they will just die. From pleasure, of course. Because this robot has been deemed a failure. Since after a couple of years, the empathic model became overwritten with its own owner's personality. And the droid suffered an existential crisis with, well, undesired consequences. So formatting, so Donald is formatting his brain once a year and thinking that it's pretty safe. I think that's a workaround, basically. Also, it's not for pleasure. Okay, so we have a freaky robot. We have few specialists. What else? And we have a dog. What about the dog? What about the dog? Fucking doctor, it's not wise to have a dog inside the lab. My ass. Jack is a bit of a asshole. Yeah, Moobot is, I think Moobot is formatted all the time, as much as possible. Because he's just making nonsense from time to time, or she, or it, or all of them at one personality, or robot. Let's play with dog. So we're again questioning, Jack is questioning actually the sergeant, whether he expected to complete his mission completely. And there's this dialogues all the time happening in this game where they're unraveling the story bit by bit, but also including this strange twists again, and you're just always thinking which way this goes. Like, you know, you're a member of two organizations and you were spent a lot of time with one, and then but you have to remember that you are in the other, so this undercover stuff usually is pretty hard and sometimes changes a lot of people, I imagine, but so it's natural for everyone to question how is it going, how is it doing. The questions about ancestors are always answered after some time. Okay, I will let you guys to go through that story yourself. Okay. So, we're in this laboratory and we're researching the antivirus for the Medusa virus. So we know what kind of what happens here, and then we're being introduced to that. So we basically have five compounds after a lot of research, and we basically will have a few months to finally complete the research. Oh, this guy is I will let that for your imagination what the hell he's doing. I will not comment on that, I'm sorry. The game meant that he's fixing the box. How is he doing that? That's a question for you guys. We have friends. Thank you, Aramazon. Thank you. Aramazon just bought the game, this game on GOG, and I'm really happy. I'm really happy that this intrigued you. Playing these games, actually, and playing these weekly staff picks are not for selling the games, actually, but it's more for... I like trying new games all the time, and these different types of games all the time, so it's very interesting for me personally to do this, and it's just a very good topic to present the weekly staff pick. So thank you again, that's awesome. Well, I don't know about the round thingy in the box. Sometimes if you push it hard and force it, you know, anything can happen. So, we have some old friends here, and they are not very happy, and let's see what they will... So they want the cure. Of course they want the cure. We have this to discover the cure by tomorrow or die. Necessity is the mother of invention. So Shaman can provide this motivation, and the C4 has been motivating people for centuries, of course. Why? This is the future, guys. C4s. Your workers in your company are not working fast enough. Just plant the fucking C4 under the seats. Everything is solved, come on. So we're not talking away our way out of this. We are being trapped. Nice. Fucking Xenolifer. God damn it. Okay. Not a very good situation to end the game in. But I will have to finish quite soon because Fleos, I think I told that correctly. Fleos, yes. He will be playing Star Wars TIE Fighter, the CD-ROM edition. Which I heard is better. Yeah. So please stay for him if you like Star Wars. And I watched the first playthrough of the TIE Fighter. It was pretty awesome, actually. So please stay for the second one also. Yes. Thank you for the next command. Yes, yeah, the crunch time has a new meaning with this one. That's actually a good idea. Maybe. Nah, I will not suggest it to GOG. Come on, it will be like. Maybe. Okay, so we are basically in this situation where we have to. We have 27 hours, we have 2.5 hours of batteries, and we have a tunnel that is blocked off. So, if we all cooperate, I will go fast through this. If we all cooperate, we can find a cure in a few places. So we will have to cross some lines here. Henito Kisu, why is this the most hated part of the game by streamers? Since I'm finishing on this, I will not be able to stream this through because Veos, I think, is preparing already for a stream. But that's actually a very interesting comment. We will cross the lines and do human experimentation. So basically, we will have to force everyone to work fast, experiment on humans, on all of these members, and see what happens, basically. And the dog is actually also injectable. So we will work in 30 minute spans, so basically at another risk. Wow, so we have a lot. Actually, we will have to manage the battery, we'll have to research the antivirus, we will have to dig the opening up, we'll have to inject people with the antivirus and see how it happens, then we'll have to test the blood, and then we'll have to recharge Brandon and the battery and all a lot of stuff. Yes, Fleos, I can. It's okay. Just let me know when you're ready. So. Let me just try and show you how it's okay. Let's go. So in here we can use the computer and research the antivirus. Yeah, guys, it's okay. I'm not finishing yet, so I can play over as much as you want. So not hour much, but 10 minutes is okay. Okay, let's research the antidote, and we have a choice even how lethal it should be, like 10, 20. 30, 40, 75, and 100%. So basically, if we research 100% antidote, it may kill the person who is injected with that, or a dog. So we can make a risky one, and let's do. So these are the components, and let's do lambda, alpha, delta, omega. La-
na dom. Ha.
Well, since it's a human experimentation, so, you know. So, we can use two people for researching an antidote. We can basically dig with all the rest. Of course you can dig, come on. Even Marvin the dog can dig. Yes, you actually have to correct the... you have to guess the right combination. And you have to dig. And you have to... check on the status, actually, of all people. I have forgotten to do that. Okay, we can start here. But if I will... select Brandon. Or BR4ND-ON. He has a... an option to request for information, and we can choose debris and performance, and he has like the information on the performance. We have to keep the track on that, and for example not to inject the person who has a very low performance with a deadly virus, and just he will die. So we will have to let them rest if we want to inject someone, and then we can inject him and test whether the antidote is okay or not. So let's work for 30 minutes. And for another 30 minutes. And let's do another 30. Is it finished? Yes, it's finished. Okay. So let's use our... Oh, crap. Let's inject the... risky antidote for Donald. Let's connect the power lines with the Brandon to actually. I hope he's not. Oh my god, 90 minutes! 90 minutes until it would work. Okay, the Brandon connecting power lines is actually charging the battery, but also damaging him at the same point. Okay, 60 minutes left for the diagnosis. Don't forget to actually start researching the other antidote, because, you know, you're just standing there doing nothing, so... Let's research a new one. A risky one. And let's go for... I don't know. Omega... Beta... Delta and Lambda. Okay. Everyone who is joining right now, Fleos will come and stream in about 5 minutes, so Don't run away, he will be here in a jiffy. Jack has been caught by... Oh my god, okay, stop working. So only doctor can defibrillate. Huh. And that's it. And now you're resting. Wow. So, Donald is up, let's analyze his blood. And what happens when you analyze the blood? Actually, first compound reacts correctly, second compound seems to work, but it's misplaced. Oh, and I don't have any pens. So it's LAD. So L is in the correct place, but ADO is misplaced. So we should stop working and abandon this one. And research the new antidote. A risky one. Gives L. Let's do load. Hello, Nightwolf. Welcome. Everyone okay? Okay, he's rested. We have to charge the defibrillator because it was used already one time. He's still not rested. The dog is. Damn it. And the dog is tired. No Marvin. No Marvin. Let's zap you a bit. So, oh no, such a little less left. Okay, we have to charge our battery. Well, maybe not yet. Maybe let's work for one more. That goo is a virus, Medusa virus. The thing that we are trying to find an antidote for right now. Let's inject ourselves with a load. Okay, playOS is ready. So, we have injected ourselves with load. And oh my god, we are not human. Thanks. I actually forgot that he's not human. So, Playos is ready for the Star Wars stream this day, today, since it's the Star Wars day. Yeah, let's do that. Thank you everyone for joining me tonight. I really, really, really hope that all of you that are scattered through all of our schedule will join us tomorrow for The Witcher QA, which will happen at oh my god, the times at 6 p.m. GMT. Let me just quickly check that. Well, you can find all the schedules, of course, on GOG. Yes, so... not 6. Yes, 6, of course, 6. So right after Outstar stream, The Witcher 3 QA, which has new gameplay, be there. After that, the UT Unreal Championship, which will knock ourselves out a lot. And it will be crazy fun. You will be really, the hype is not for nothing. It's really, really, really awesome. I hope you liked this game. I should have streamed that for narrative mode from the beginning, and it will be a lesson, I hope, for the future. So, without further ado, thank you for joining me. Follow me in the channels if you like what I'm doing. Follow GOG, of course, and check out this game on weekly stuff picks. It's on promo right now. That's it. To you, Playos, and may the 4th be with you. Thank you, guys. Ciao.